Good morning. How are you today? My name is Nasreen, and today we will make many exercises about how we can calculate the acceleration. The first example: on a straight line, there is a moving bus whose speed changes from 6 meters per second to 12 meters per second. During a period of 3 seconds, what is the value of acceleration? Another time, on a straight line, there is a moving bus whose speed changes from 6 meters per second to 12 meters per second. Who can tell me which of these speeds is V1 and which of them is V2? He said that the speed changes from 6 to 12. So 6 meters per second is the value of speed number 1, or V1, the stored speed. And 12 is related to the value of the final speed, V2. During a period of 3 seconds, so 3 seconds is the value of the time. So, we will write 12 minus 6 divided 3. Please don't forget to write the law. Before entering the problem, you must write the law. We said that in the last session, that the acceleration equal delta V divided delta T. And delta V equal V2 minus V1 divided the time. And we said that V2 equal 12, V1 6, so 12 minus 6 divided 3 equal 2 meter per second squared. Meter per second square is the measuring unit of acceleration. And don't forget to write the measuring unit. في النهاية, you must write two important steps. The first step, you must write the law before answering the problem. لازم نكتب القانون قبل ما نحل المسألة. حتى لو انت عارف القانون لازم تكتبه. كل ده بناخد عليه درجات. And we must write the measuring unit. لازم نكتب وحدة القياس بتاعة الحاجة اللي احنا بنحسبها. Okay. Example number 2. A driver used the brake to stop the car moved by 20 meters per second. قبل ما نكمل قراية الاكزامبل نترجم السطر اللي احنا قلناه ده. Driver used the brake to stop the car. بمعنى ان الكار بتاعتي move by speed. Excellent. السبيد بقى هنا اللي كان ماشية بيها العربية في الاول is 20 meter per second. So 20 meter per second is related to the started speed اللي هي V1. But the driver used the brake to stop. So V2, اللي هي ال ended speed, is 0. طيب احنا قلنا قبل ما نحل المسألة we must. Yes, excellent. Write the law. لازم نكتب القانون. طيب. Calculate the time taken by the car to stop. In this type of exercise, we want to calculate the value of time, not acceleration. Given that the acceleration of the body equal 1 meter per second squared. At first, we will write the law of acceleration equal delta V divided delta T. Yes, excellent. I hear you. And we will write that acceleration equal V2. Minus V1 divided the time, and we said that V2 equals 0 because the car is stopped, and V1 is 20 divided the unknown time that we want to calculate على التايم اللي احنا محتاجين نحسبه. Now we have an important question. In the example, we know that the acceleration of the body equal 1 meter per second. هو مديني في المسألة ان الاكسلريشن 1 متر بير سكند. ليه احنا عوضنا في المسألة ان الاكسلريشن حطينا قدام ال 1 ده نيجاتيف 1 نوت بوزيتيف 1 رغم ان هو في المسألة بيقول لي 1. Because the speed of the car decreases. Because the speed of the car decreases. السرعة بتاعة العربية قلت. When the speed decreases, we will write the acceleration with negative sign. So negative 1 equals 0, negative 20 divided unknown time. So time equal negative 20 second. Don't forget to write the measuring unit. Example number 3. If a boat starts to move from rest, till its speed become 2.5 meter per second through 5 seconds. If a boat starts to move from rest, till its speed become 2.5 meter per second through 5 seconds. Before we read the بقيت المسألة, we want to know the value of V2 and the value of V1. Who can tell me the value of V2 and the value of V1? Okay, let's read it again. If a boat starts to move from rest, so the boat is stopped at first. So the value of V1 will be equal 0. Excellent. Because the boat was stopped and its speed become 2.5 meter per second. معنى كده ان ال V2 بقت 2.5 meter per second and the time is 5 seconds. So he wanted to calculate, number one, the acceleration of the moving boat. We wanted to calculate the acceleration. We must write the law at first. Okay, yes, I know that you know the law. Excellent. Acceleration equal delta V divided delta T. So acceleration V2 minus V1. And we said that V2, its value is 2.5. And V1, its value is... yes, 0 excellent divided the 5 second equal half meter per second square. Okay, he wanted to know the type of acceleration. The value of acceleration in the problem was positive sound. Positive value. So, the type of acceleration will be positive acceleration. Because the speed increases and the value of acceleration was the positive sign, not negative sign. Example number 4. A moving car starts from rest and its speed increases to 15 meter per second through 5 seconds. And another car whose movement starts from rest and increases to 20 meter per second through 10 seconds. Which of the two cars is moving at a greater acceleration? So we will... excellent. We will calculate the value of acceleration for the two cars. The first car and the second car. And we will write at first the law that acceleration equal V2 minus V1 divided the time. Okay, now we want to know the value of V2 and V1 for each of the cars. Number one, the first car starts from rest So V1 equal excellent 0, and the speed become 15. So V2 equal 15, and the time is 5. 15 minus 0 divided 5 equal 3 meter per second square, and the value of acceleration in the second car, he said that the second car starts from rest and increase to 20 meter per second. So V1 equals 0 and V2 equal 20, and the time given in the problem equal 10 seconds. So 20 minus 0 divided 10 equal 2 meter per second. So the acceleration of the first car is greater than the acceleration of the second car. Finally, I hope all of you to understand this lesson, and thank you for listening.